Hi, everybody. It's Steve, and welcome to another edition of Steve Ludwig's Classic Pop Culture at planetludwig.com. And this week, show number 69, in addition to my brother Bill Ludwig's weekly album cuts segment, our very special guest is Miss Ginger Alden. Ginger Alden, as you know, is Elvis Presley's fiancée and certainly Elvis's last love at the very unfortunate time of Elvis's death. Ginger has written a wonderful book called Elvis and Ginger, and we're going to talk all things Elvis and Ginger with Miss Ginger Alden in just a few moments. But first...
Just the king.
The king.
He's the king.
The king of music.
King. He is king.
He's the king. He's great. I love him.
He's the king.
He will always be the king, no matter what.
I think he's a good, clean fellow.
I've been to his home many times, touched the gate and everything. That just turns me on just to do that. What's he going to do when I watch him tonight? They've got an ambulance waiting by.
If he said, come along, let's go, I wouldn't look back.
Imagine he'll still be as good looking as he always was, just older.
Yes, I was in love with him.
Oh, he's such a sexy person.
I'm not a spring chicken anymore.
He's great.
I've got a daughter about 12 years old, and I've talked about Elvis and about how great he was when I was growing up. She has no idea who the man is. And I think a kid can't grow up without knowing who Elvis Presley is.
We are retired people, and all ages come to see him, I think.
Oh, I'm so nervous I can't stand it.
He's so special and everything, and he's the best-looking guy in the world.
This is about my 28th concert since 1972.
Elvis means to me a legend.
I'm so excited. I could just, oh, I can't wait.
Remember when they used to swoon? Well, she's gonna. And we're gonna take real good care of her. We have a doctor and everything just to... I'm not kidding. You think I am? She was looking at his program tonight, and she got so excited we had to give her artificial respiration.
Really? He's always been a favorite of
this
mine.
This is her wedding present. Come here. I want you to meet her new husband.
Yes, this,
hi,
we're on. They just got married.
We're honeymooners.
He's honest. That's the main thing. He's honest. And he's got vibes, you know? And that's what we enjoy. This is my son, and he's been an Elvis fan since he's been 3 years old.
Well, I've seen him about five times.
He's my number one singer of all time. Hope to name my kid after him someday. He keeps his political views to himself. I just love the guy. I mean, I know that sounds kind of weird, but I just love the guy, and I wish him many years of success.
I've gotten to know him in a way from seeing him on stage, and I would say he is religious to the point where, of course, he can't go to church like many other people can every week, but you can see by the way he sings a lot of these spiritual songs.
The official Elvis Presley fan club of Great Britain and the Commonwealth is probably the world's largest Elvis Presley fan club. We boast a membership in excess of 12,000 members, and that's a live membership. It's not one that we keep adding members to each year. We're a very active fan club. In fact, we take members all over Europe on mini weekend holidays, and we have conventions in Great Britain, which we raise huge sums of money for charity. We all expected Elvis Presley to be about 12 feet tall, with an aurora around his head and a fanfare, but of course it wasn't like that, and he was everything that everybody says he was, a very natural, quite shy sort of person.
Elvis is very important to me because I've been an Elvis fan for 20 years. There is so much in the guy. He is the biggest entertainer to me and the biggest to 1,000 others.
I started my fan club about 5 years ago, and I have about 1,000 members.
And where is the fan club?
In Brussels.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Wayne Newton. Now, I'd like to say that it's a pleasure to be here. And somebody told me that it is a new building or something, and I was the first person to perform here. Is that true? Yeah. I'll see y'all later. Now, we're going to do a lot of songs, old ones, new ones, and I hope we'll do something that you like. And we're here to entertain you and to make you happy. So just enjoy yourself and leave the driving to us.
Are you lonesome tonight? Do you miss me tonight? Are you sorry we drifted apart? Does your memory stray to a bright summer day when I kissed you and called you sweetheart? Do the chairs in your parlor seem empty and bare? Do you gaze at your doorstep and picture me there? Is your heart filled with pain? Shall I come back again? Tell me, dear, are you lonesome too? I wonder if you're lonesome tonight. You know, someone said the world's a stage and each of us play a part. Faith had me playing in plus tags. You read your lines so cleverly and never missed a cue. They came back too. You forgot the words, seemed to change, you fool. You acted strange, and why I've never known. Why ever did it? Honey, who am I talking to? You lied when you said you loved me. I had no cause to doubt you. But I think go on hearing your lies and to go on living without you. Now the stage is bare, and I'm standing there without any hair. I know. And you won't come back to me. What the heck with you? Is your heart filled with pain? Shall I come back again? Tell me, dear, are you lonesome tonight?
I'd like you to say hello to my girlfriend, Ginger. Ginger, stand up, honey. Sit down, Ginger. It's enough for her.
Baby, let me be your loving teddy bear. Put a chain around my neck and leave me anywhere. Oh, let me be. Baby. Tigers play too rough. I don't really lie. Lions ain't the kind of an eye. So won't I go on teddy bear? Put a chain around my neck and lead me anywhere. Oh, let me be a teddy bear. Oh, let me be. You know I can be found sitting home all alone. If you can't come around, at least please telephone. Don't be cool, your heart is true. Baby, if I made you mad, something that I might have said, please just forget the past. The future looks bright ahead. Don't be cool, your heart is true. Yeah, I don't want no other love. Maybe it's just you. Don't be cruel to our history. be cruel to a heart that's true. Yeah, I don't want no other love. Baby, it's just that you are thinking of. Yeah.
Okay.
Woo.
Thank you.
Kato proudly presents an important new album by the one and only Elvis Presley. Elvis, at his soulful best, singing 20 songs of inspiration. Inspirations by Elvis Presley. From Kato.
Elvis Presley, I'd like to say hello to all the listeners in Australia.
Elvis by Request, the Australian Fan Edition. Featuring 40 songs voted by you, the Elvis fan. With classic songs and fan favorites. You voted, we made the album. Discover Australia's number one Elvis song. On Elvis by Request, the Australian Fan Edition. It's your Elvis album.
Good. We can finally start the big meeting. Donnie, Chuck.
Let's begin, shall we? Shall we?
And how you doing, everybody? Welcome to another edition of Steve Ludwig's Classic Pop Culture. This is your pal and fellow fan of pop culture, Steve Ludwig. Here we are, show number 69. How the heck did we get to show number 69 so quickly? And it is such a special show. As I mentioned at the top, Miss Ginger Alden is our guest, and we'll be speaking with Miss Alden in just about 10 minutes from now. I just want to tell you a couple of things. First of all, we taped our interview. I taped my interview with Ms. Alden last week. And when I was listening to the replay, I realized I had said in the intro that Ms. Alden is Elvis Presley's fiance. Of course, I should have spoken in the past tense, but other than that, I think I got everything right. So that our interview with Ginger will be coming up in about 10 minutes. And I want to dedicate this show to all of us fans of Elvis Presley who love him so much and loved his music and still love his music. And especially, I want to dedicate this show to my sister-in-law, Liz Vasquez. She is such a big Elvis Presley fan. She loves him, as we all do. So, Liz, and all of us other Elvis fans, this one's for you, okay? Now, last week we had Carl Green, co-founder and original bassist of Herman's Hermits, and horror novelist Dino Sands. I want to thank both of them for a wonderful show last week. And I forgot to mention last week that I actually wanted to thank a good friend of the show, Zainab Ali. She has a horror blog called The Nightmare Nook, and I want to thank Zainab for introducing me to Dino Sands. I had meant to mention that last week, but I forgot. So I'm sorry, Zainab. So this week, want to let you know I appreciate it very much, Sam. Next week, from one of the all-time great TV shows, My Three Sons, we knew him as Chip Douglas on that show. Actor, artist, producer Stanley Livingston will be our guest next week. Going to be another great show. Couple of things. I want to ask you to like us on Facebook, Steve Ludwig's Classic Pop Culture. Hey, we love you guys. All we want to do is you to like us. All right, so like us on Facebook, Steve Ludwig's Classic Pop Culture. Follow us on Twitter, at Ludguy, LUDGUY, at Ludguy. Follow us on Instagram, planet_Ludwig. That's because we're at planetludwig.com. And hey, while you're at it, why don't you download our free mobile app, Planet Ludwig. Just search for Planet Ludwig on your apps in your app store. You can also hear us on Spreaker, Stitcher, iTunes free download, TuneIn Radio. You can take us everywhere and anywhere. Okay, I think I'm done talking enough now, right? I know we all want to hear from Ginger Alden. And just before that, every week, we have a special segment. My brother Bill, who has the greatest album collection in the world, allows us into his vault. So it is now time, once again, for Bill's